I'm Seamus Dunhuo of EVE University, and this is episode 26 of How to Survive EVE Online. For reference, it's been about 12 hours since I did my last recording, so there has been some time spent training skills in that time. I finished missile launcher operation level 2, so I'm going to go ahead and inject standard missiles. By the way, the option to train now to level 1 isn't visible in the right-click menu if you've already got the training queue open. I'm going to throw in standard missiles. I only need level 1, but I think I'll throw it up to level 2 since it won't take too long. And I'm going to click apply. Let's see. Right-click civil Aeron, start conversation. And cash flow for Capsuleer is 4 of 10. He wants us to warp to a dead space area, find the Stargate, and approach it. Alright, let's click accept. And the game will provide text for you to read about shield tanking. Let me close this. Shield tanking will probably be important to you if you are Kaldari or Minmitar. The Galente and the Amar tend to armor tank, but there are exceptions. You can fit any given ship in various different ways. So let me make my Atron active. Let me double check my fitting window. There isn't actually any combat involved here, but I will load my weapons anyway, and I have my afterburner and small armor repair. I think I am all set. I'm going to undock. We are in space. Right-click empty space. Cash flow for Capsuleer is 4 of 10. Encounter of dead space warp to location. Now, something to keep in mind. I've mentioned this before. To go to warp, your ship must already be traveling towards the destination within about a five degree variance, and going at least 75% of your current maximum speed. So if you're not already meeting those conditions when you try to go to warp, your ship will try to turn to align to warp before it actually enters warp. If it can't align, it's not going to go to warp. That's going to be very important in this mission because you've got this gigantic obstacle that might be in your way, depending upon where the station is located, where the mission is located. In my particular case, I happen to be conveniently located with the station right behind me along a nice clear path, but you might have to manually fly your way in to avoid bumping into obstacles, because if you're trying to get around obstacles on your way out, you might take more serious damage than you really intended. If you look at local channel, and the mission talks to, sends text at you in local channel, let's double-click away from this thing and hit the afterburner. Your computer detects gas and radioactive materials spewing out of the Stargate at frightening speed. It would be best to leave immediately before your ship starts to take damage. And you notice your shields are taking damage right now. You might have to get clear of any obstacles manually by double-clicking in space before you try to align to warp. Now in this case, I am plenty clear of any obstacles, so I can turn off the afterburner, left click the station, hit dock.
Warp drive active.
I'm an armor tanker, so I don't care if... And that would be the shield alarm. I'm an armor tanker, so I don't care if my shields go down. Or at least I'm armor tanking right now. Sometimes I fly shield tank ships. If you left-click this options button to the lower right of the capacitor donut, you can go to audio alerts, and you can turn on or off the various warnings. The shield warning should probably be at 25% because that's your peak shield regeneration rate. The shields go up on their own, just like the capacitor goes up on its own, and they both follow the same recharge pattern. They both recharge fastest at 25% and slower at any other fraction. Armor will not recharge or repair on its own. You actually need a module to do that for you. Or pay for repairs in station in a repair shop, but that can get expensive for larger ships. I like to set my armor threshold to 66%. And the hull breach warning, keep it at 95%. So you get, if you start taking hull damage, you get that warning pretty early on. You know what? Let's set that to 99%. Alright, let's close that. Talk to Civil Aeron. Start conversation. Complete the mission. The game will talk about afterburners. Although it doesn't actually give you the afterburner skill book, which was why I had you purchase that skill book earlier. In the next episode, we will take on the next step of this chain. In the meantime, thank you for watching.